Talking to many beginner forex traders, I think I've come up with the main reason, or one of the main reason why beginner forex trader or even some of the advanced forex trader blow up the accounts. So according to my research and according to the way I've seen other beginner traders trade, one of the main reasons that caused them to blow up the account is what they call the fear of missing out, or FOMO. FOMO just stands for fear of missing out. So on this video today, I want to be able to cover the steps, or even the cause of FOMO, and also how you can be able to avoid it on your trading. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Ndema Zegolov. On this channel, we talk everything about trading, business, travel, personal finance, and tips to help you stay profitable as a forex trader. So if this is your first time coming to my channel, or if you're watching my content and you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button below so that you can be able to stay informed once I come up with videos like this. I've come up with many challenges, and a lot of challenges or a lot of trading I've done on a live account. Many people come up to me and they show me, when I see their own trading history, I see them doing the same mistakes over and over and over and over again. The forex market is still going to be there even 100 years to come, even 200 years to come. The market is still going to be there. The trades are still going to be there. The opportunities are still going to be there. So the fear of missing out, FOMO, is still called FOMO. Maybe you've heard other traders mentioning it, or the fear of missing out is something you should be able to practice, and you should be able to practice how to avoid it, or how to be able to remove that aspect, that particular catalyst from your trading. So what are even some of the causes of the fear of missing out? The main cause of the fear of missing out is what they call greed. It's greed. When you are greedy, when you are trading, sometimes you just have to accept the fact that you are risking what you can afford to lose. When you risk what you can afford to lose, then be able to accept whatsoever the market offers you that particular day, that particular week, that particular month, or that particular year, and move out of the market. You see, that's why they say the market doesn't owe you anything. So if you have that opportunity, we're trading with probabilities. We trade forex with probability. Even you placing your trade, you're placing your trade based on probabilities. That, okay, according to my technical analysis, according to my fundamental analysis, this trade might go my way. So we're working according to probability. So if you're working on that probability and the probability falls on your edge and you have the opportunity to make profit, then be satisfied with whatsoever you make from the market. Whether it's $1, whether it's $10, $20, $100, $1,000, $10,000, be satisfied with it and move out of the market. So greed, try to remove greed from your trading. With greed, that's when you see some people, you can even, like sometimes when I used to help some people with Signal, I would tell somebody, maybe, okay, buy this particular currency pair. Then maybe the person wasn't on the computer at that particular point in time. They take 30 minutes after, the person is trembling, the person is so traumatized, the person is so worried because he or she missed that particular trade. No, maybe we're even just talking about USD, Japanese yen, or Great Britain pound, Japanese yen. If you go to another currency pair, there's still going to be hundreds and hundreds of opportunities on that same currency, on that different currency pair. So maybe you're thinking in your brain that, okay, I've missed this opportunity, that's all for the day. No, there are a lot and a lot of opportunity. In forex alone, we have 22 pairs. We have 22 major pairs. 22 major pairs that you can trade. And out of those 22 major pairs, there's no forex trader that can open the chart. And even if you see these forex traders that have 200 chart, they have many computers and stuff like that, at the end of the day, they can't see half of the opportunities. They can't capture half of the opportunities in the market, because the opportunities are too many. So if you miss one trade opportunity, if you miss one news event, you miss one technical analysis trade, don't worry yourself. It's better for you to preserve your capital to live to trade another day than to blow up your capital in one day because of greed and because of the fear of missing out. All right. So number two, the second point that I've also seen that motivate people to be able to suffer from FOMO or the fear of missing out is lack of trading plan. The lack of a trading plan. They don't have a trading plan. They just trading like that, like the wind. You know, when the wind is blowing, it can just take them in any direction. When they just enter the market today, if somebody just maybe call them on the phone and say, buy this. You see them, they just start buying. I mean, they have no plan. They go into trading without any plan. That is why it is very important. They say, have a plan and trade your plan. Okay? Make a plan and trade your plan. That's the key thing in Forex. When you have your plan, make sure you stick to your plan. Have your journal down anything you trade, the reasons why that trade didn't go your way and stuff like that. When you have that particular mentality, that particular focus and that particular plan, you become satisfied, you become contented with any other thing that the market has to give you for that particular day. All right, so we've talked about greed and also on lack of a trade plan. So how can you avoid the fear of missing out? To avoid the fear of missing out, the number one point, the first thing you have to do, you have to treat trading like a business. You have to treat trading like a business instead of gambling. Because when you treat trading like a business, you understand that like a business, you need to give yourself, you need to give that trading or that account some time to mature. That life cycle that you're giving the account to mature is a time you're also giving your mentality to be able to capture some skills, to be able to learn new, to be able to learn the market environment, to be able to learn new news events and stuff like that. So you have to be able to treat trading like a business instead of gambling. Like a business, obviously, you know you need a plan. You need to have a reason why you buy a particular currency pair. You need to have a reason why you need to have points that will tell you how to exit from that particular currency pair. You need to have a plan that shows you how to manage that particular trade. Because the main thing is not just for you. Any person can just place buy and sell. It doesn't take any skill to make a winner trade in Forex, but it takes skills to be a consistent, profitable trader. All right? Understand this. It doesn't take any skill. Even your mom or even your father or your grandmom, if you just carry the computer and give them, you just need to show your grandmom the buy or the sell button. They can, if they click any button and they're lucky, they can still make money. It doesn't take any skill to place a winning trade in Forex, but it takes keys to be a consistently profitable trader. Okay? So make sure you have your plan, follow your plan, and treat trading like a business instead of trading like a gamble. Another point that I want to be able to point out is have a checklist. You should have something like a checklist. I used to have like a checklist that before I place any particular trade, I go through my checklist. My trade must fall between all those points of confluences. My trade plan, it must fall between that checklist. Maybe, for example, I'm trading support and resistance. Okay, according to my checklist, I'll write that, okay, the market has to be able to test this particular zone. When it tests that particular zone, that will be my first tick. I'll think, okay, the market has already tested that particular zone. Maybe according to my trading plan, I also wrote that, okay, if the market tests that particular zone, I'm waiting for a signal that shows me that the market is going to change direction. That signal can be a double bottom, can be a double top, can be an engulfing candle. There are many reversal signals, okay? It can be a head and shoulder pattern. So when I see any of those signals, I tick again. Okay, sometimes I can even use maybe another tool. So I have a list that, okay, before I place a particular trade, I've gone through my list and I've ticked everything. Then I just place my trade, put my money management rule, anything in place, then I let the trade do its thing because I've already done my own part. When you are trading like that, you remove yourself from being psychologically beaten because you don't know what you are doing. So have something like a checklist. And I'll have to tell you this, the Forex market is so big. You can't even, the Forex market alone is $6 trillion. The transaction per day is $6 trillion. So us retail traders, the whole retail traders in the world, we cover just about 10% of the whole retail traders industry. So the market is so vast. If you miss an opportunity, you don't need to worry yourself. You don't need to suffer from FOMO, from the fear of missing out. No, if you miss an opportunity, let it go. Even if you miss a day of trading, even if you miss a week of trading. For me, sometimes I used to take up to 3 weeks when I'm traveling, when I'm going to Egypt sometimes, Switzerland or Cameroon. When I'm traveling sometimes, I just go out of the market. I can even take 2 weeks to myself. I know that when I come back after that 2 weeks, my capital is still preserved. The market will still be there. I'll still be able to place those same trades. So be able to know that the forex market is still going to be there. The opportunities per day, the opportunities in the forex market are so vast. So if you miss one trade, you don't need to beat up yourself. You don't need to be psychologically beaten because you miss that trade. You don't need to overstress your mind and stuff just because you miss that particular trade. So let it go. Come back to go back to your drawing board, check what you did wrong, then you gradually bounce back and you'll be able to start again as usual. So this has wrapped up to the end of this video, and if you've gotten some value from this video so far, please leave a thumb up on the video. It means a lot. It means a lot to my channel. It means a lot to the algorithm, and it also tells me you guys like content like this, and I'll be able to create more. So leave a thumbs up on the video, and also subscribe to the channel. Until then, I'll see you guys on the next video.